Welcome to the tutorial on editing the sharing permissions of your ePortfolio site. When you first create your ePortfolio site, you can see as you roll over the share button in the upper right corner that your ePortfolio is private only to you. That means that you are the only person who is able to see that ePortfolio site. At some point down the road after creating your site, you will need to share your site with other individuals, either other students, definitely some instructors, maybe your advisor. There's lots of reasons you will want to share your ePortfolio site with someone else. So to change the sharing permissions, you're going to go up to the upper right corner and click on the share button. And this will take you into the manage site area for sharing and permissions. In this area, you have a variety of options of how you would like to share your site. One of the first options would be just to invite individual people by name that you may choose to share your site with. So you should be able to type in an individual's name. This will be searching anyone within the Fisher network, so faculty, staff, or students at Fisher, and you can locate them by their name, select the individual that you're looking for, and then make sure that you set the permissions on this right-hand side to the correct level. So usually with your ePortfolio site, you're not giving anyone else edit rights to your site. You're only giving them view rights so that they can see your site and you're sharing the contents of it with them. So you can add an individual, you can put multiple people's names in the list at the same time. You can then also notify them. You may add a message to the notification if you choose to, and you can also choose to send a copy of this notification to yourself so that you have a record of it. So that's one way to add individual people to share your site just with a few folks. Now, in the beginning, that may be fine. You may only have a few others that you need to share your site with, but at some point, there will probably be more and more people that you need to share your site with, and it can become time consuming to add every single person that you need to see it by name. So your other option may be to ignore this whole invite people area at the bottom and instead go up here to the top and focus on this area of who has access. So right now this is telling me that I am the only one that has access to my site. I'm the owner, and otherwise it is private only to me. But I can use this change button to change those settings. So if I click on change, now I have what is really kind of a sliding scale of how private or how public I might want this site to be. So leaving it at the lowest level again means that it's shared with only individual people. The next level up means that anyone at SJFC or anyone who has a Fisher username and password, that includes faculty, staff, or students, and those that you have shared the link with to your ePortfolio site can log in and access your ePortfolio site and can view it. The second level, medium level here, is that anyone within the Fisher network still, so again, faculty, staff, or students at Fisher, can actually find and access your site even if you don't provide them the link. And that means that they can go into Google Sites, they could search by your last name, and your site would appear and they could look at it. The next level would be actually allowing anyone outside of Fisher. So even those who do not have a Fisher name and username and password would be able to access your site, but they do need a link so that you would have to be emailing them or sharing a link with them directly to access your site. This is a good level if you are working with anyone with your ePortfolio and you would like to share it with an outside member, maybe for an internship, maybe a manager for someone where you work, maybe an application for grad school, things like that. The highest level would be completely public on the web, where someone could actually really just Google your information, Google your name, and your ePortfolio site may pop up so that they could locate it that way. This is something that we really don't recommend students do with their ePortfolio site. It just opens up the site to a lot of other security risks. Usually, the highest level we recommend is this fourth level up so that anyone, even outside of Fisher, but only those that you've sent the link to, can access the site. And again, this is good when you get close to graduation or after graduation. Usually, while you're still a Fisher student, this middle level is the best option. Okay, so you would choose the level that works for you. Again, make sure that this is set up so that they can only view the site, not edit the site, and then click Save. That will take you back to the previous page. You can now see that who has access to the site is anyone at Fisher, and they can find and view the site. They cannot edit. And also on this page, an important area to note is the link to share, as this is the area where you can copy and paste the link that you might include in an email or on your resume or in other documents for those individuals who you want to access your site. When you're done with sharing permissions, you're going to use this option, navigate back to your ePortfolio site.